just start off with a brief opening statement about the game, and then you guys can ask your questions.
Well, you know, I felt it was a tale of two halves. I mean, you know, things that we've been working on. We got 60 points in the second half. We tried every defense we had, so we struggled a little bit. But we, you know, we turned the ball over in critical possessions, and we gave up an open three, five, six on the shot clock. So that was a big turning point of the game. We couldn't. It's kind of been this team so far where we play a good 20 minutes, one half. We have to be able to put 40 together.
Trey, would you say that the schedule and the inconsistency with the long breaks played a factor in the second half today?
I mean, that's an excuse, but I do think, you know, coming into it, we talked about it. Yeah, I thought about it in my head a little bit. You know, we've been practicing for 12 straight days. You know, knowing it's just like getting in a rhythm in anything you do. Like, we haven't been in a rhythm to go play a second half. So I don't think it had an effect on us. But do I think it, you know, we're looking forward to league play coming up where we can play two games in a week.
You had, there were two instances late in the second half where they would have the ball and you guys were in a situation where you would want to foul, but you were able to run off a few seconds off the clock. Was there a lack of communication there, or is that just?
No, it was the player you're talking about was probably 16 seconds. We thought down one, it was our possession arrow. We thought we'd try to go for a steal quickly and try to take it away from them. And then, you know, they ran it off to us 8 or 9. And,
we have Asante gets there. If you guys have any questions for Asante.
Guys, for both you guys, I guess you put this game in the rearview mirror, but just kind of going forward, I guess you have a chance to play a ranked team now in Colorado, right? What kind of opportunity is that to put this game behind you and try to take out a ranked team?
Well, I think that, you know, we had to put 40 minutes together. You know, I thought today, probably 25, even the start of the second half, we were okay, and then we kind of faltered a little bit there the last 15 minutes, 14 minutes of the second half. It's early in the season, you know, we're still trying to integrate a lot of new guys, and, you know, with the schedule like it is, I mean, we're still trying to get to know each other. Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't say we're excited about going to play a ranked team right now, yeah. But I mean, not to say at this moment, you know, but we'll be ready, we'll get better, we'll continue to get better as a team. I think Asante right here, I mean, I thought he played really well tonight.
Follow that up, Asante. We spoke over supper about how, with all the new pieces on this team, it was a matter of just getting them to gel and really start getting into a groove with each other. How much progress do you feel you've made in that regard?
I'm feeling as though we've made some progress. You know, it's kind of difficult for us because, you know, the coach not being here, and then as well as also being, you know, coach Arm does a great job with us, you know, and everything like that. But, you know, as far as, like, everybody being new and we having, like, not a lot of time with each other, so it's kind of been a little bit hard for us. But I feel as though, you know, we come into practice every single day, and everybody just keep trying to work hard. And even if we fail, we understand that it's not about who we are now; it's about who we are in the season. So that's kind of our mindset, and that's what coach instills in us every single day, and tells us that we're going to be a good team when it's all said and done. So that's just really our mindset. So I feel as though we're going to gel, and everything will be fine for us.
And for both of you, what can you say about Tawan's effort today? Started off a little slow and then battled back in the second half, especially when Princeton's big went into foul trouble.
Yeah, I mean, I thought early he passed the ball well, out of, you know, and got guys open shots. I think he, you know, we're up 9 or 8, and he misses a dunk. Turned the ball over a couple times in the second half. But overall, I mean, he gave us great effort. All the guys did. I mean, we, you know, last year was my first year here, and, you know, we started off slow, too. And our goal is to be playing our best basketball in February and March.
You had talked, so far you've talked a couple times about not having put together a complete 40 minutes. Is there a reason why? Is it just youth having a lot of young guys in, or not even as an experienced team?
You know, it's multiple different things. I mean, like this week, for instance, we had, you know, 6-7 guys with the flu coming into this game. Didn't practice until like 2 days ago. So, I mean, it was a trying week for us. But I thought we did come out and put our best foot forward and saw improvement in the first half. some of the second half was good things. We just didn't still got to build. We got to get better where we can play 15 more minutes. So it'll be a full 40-minute game.
And Ken Curtis here with WVOX and Rochelle. Asante, this is also about the jumper you made at the end of regulation, diving into 73 from the left side. That was a key shot.
Well, me personally, I thought it was a three. I thought my foot was on the line, but when we looked at it, my foot was on the line. It was a great pass by Isaiah, and I just, I'm confident in myself, so I just knocked down the shot. And felt as though we were going to have a good chance at overtime to win, but we didn't get it done there.
Asante, you mentioned Coach. Does he text with you guys? Is he in touch with you guys at all?
Yes, he keeps in contact with us all the time. He texts us before every game. He keeps in contact with me personally, so it's
what kind of stuff does he say to you?
Just being the leader on the team, just talking to the guys, telling them what they got to do, telling them that we got to, come with that with a different mindset on a daily basis, and just kind of instill some of the things that he was here to them, and just keeping our spirits up, because what we're going through right now. But everything, like I said, Coach Arnold does a great job with us, and everything will work itself out. I'm not worried at all.
For Asante and Trey, to follow up on Adam's question, how much, and I'm sure you've been asked this pretty much every day, how much do you miss not having Tim available to you guys?
I mean, I think that, he's actually still with us. I mean, just not there. I mean, every day, me and him talk. We talk about practice. We talk about games. I mean, he's a legend. He's a great coach. But he's coaching us through this situation right now. So, of course, we miss him. But, he's instilling in us. I mean, we're going about it. I mean, he did it for 9 to 10 years. And every day of practice, he has mapped out over there. It's the same things with a little bit of tweak here and there. But other than that, I mean, he's still with us.
Coach is asking about Isaiah Washington as a newcomer from Minnesota. How has it been implementing him into the rotation, into your backcourt?
He's a new guy. That's a big cog, for us. I thought tonight he played better. I think he struggled a little bit early in the season. And it's about playing the kinks out, playing, getting some reps, playing well. I thought he made some good drives at home and made some good passes today. He's still got to be holding himself more accountable on the other end defensively, but he'll get there. He'll get to where we need him.
And another newcomer, Dylan Van Eck, forward. Tell us, gives you some size. What do you see his role being?
An energy guy that plays hard. I don't think he's a good shooter, too. A guy that can rebound for us. Bring energy every night.
Two more? Okay. All right, thanks, guys.
Thanks, guys. Good luck.